Welcome back to the Gridiron Expert. Maryland and Virginia Tech both had to win their final game just to make the Pinstripe Bowl. But despite being in similar situations, both teams seem to be heading in opposite directions. Maryland finally made a bowl game under Mike Loxley, their first bowl game since 2016. The Terrapins looking to win their first bowl game since 2010. Virginia Tech, they fired Justin Fuente. They've got an interim head coach for this bowl game in J.C. Price, and then Brent Pry from Penn State. He's going to take over as the new head man in Blacksburg. So both these teams, guys, again, need to win that final game, but Maryland might seem to be trending up, maybe gaining some momentum finally under Mike Loxley, while Virginia Tech, they're kind of having to hit rebuild mode and really are probably just ready for the season to end. But regardless, guys, we are here to break down everything you need to know for this Pinstripe Bowl. Who's going to win? Will it be the Terrapins? Will it be the Hokies? We're here to tell you right now. But as always, make sure to continue to like, comment, subscribe, share our videos, guys. That helps our channel grow, that boosts our analytics, helps us share more college football content with you guys year-round, 24/7. 365. And of course, make sure to check out everything down in the description below as well. If you want the spread pick for this Pinstripe Bowl, our pick against the spread for this Pinstripe Bowl, and our spread pick for every single college football bowl game, go sign up for our expert picks over on the gridironexpert.com. It's some of the best picks in the country for one of the lowest prices in the country. And we're going to factor in some NFL spread picks as well, including every single NFL playoff game. So if you've not already, make sure to sign up for our expert picks, guys. Again, the link is down in the description below. It will be one of the best decisions you make all year. And keep in mind, it is a year-long subscription. So you buy now, and you get all the way through 2022. So make sure to join our team. Again, the link down in the description. So let's take a look, guys. Let's take a look at the offense. We'll take a look at the offense first. And we'll start with Maryland, the team that, as we said, kind of seems to be trending in the right direction. And if you've watched Maryland football or you know anything about the talent they have or just Mike Loxley and his philosophy, Maryland right now, they're all about passing. The Terrapins are averaging 27.3 points per game, are averaging a whopping 307.1 passing yards per game. And they're doing that with their quarterback in Talia Tungavailoa, the brother of Tua Tungavailoa. Talia has thrown for over 3,500 yards, 24 touchdowns, just 11 interceptions. The Terrapins have the 13th ranked passing offense in the country. That's a major reason, first off, for their fast start. You know, Maryland started 4-0, but went 2-6 down the stretch, only won two games after that fast start. But they have the 13th ranked passing offense in the country, Tungavailoa leading that, connecting time and time again with Rakeem Jarrett, who, if you remember a couple years ago, surprised everybody by committing to Maryland. And Jarrett has over 760 reception yards and 5 touchdowns. You want to look at Maryland's offense outside of the passing game, which is what they want to do first. It's obviously their strength. They have a decent run game, 130 rushing yards per game. They've got Tayon Fleet Davis, who has rushed for over 660 yards and 8 touchdowns. So this is a, you know, when you look at this, guys, when you look at teams, every team has a strength typically. They want to run first, they want to pass first. Maryland's obviously passing first, but it's important to have some sort of balance or some decent numbers on the opposite end to try to take that pressure off of your strength. So in this case, Fleet Davis in that running game can take a little pressure off of Tungavailoa if the passing game goes south, or they're just trying to mix it up, trying to stay a little bit balanced against this Virginia Tech defense. When you look at the Hokies, they're in a tough spot. A very tough spot because of all of the transfers and opt-outs they've had since firing Justin Fuente. And obviously, many players believing that we've got a new head coach coming in. I don't want to be here for that. It's a meaningless bowl game, some would say. So Virginia Tech, down a lot. I would say none bigger than their quarterback, Braxton Burmeister, their backup quarterback in Knox Kadum, their leading wide receiver in Trey Turner, and their number two wide receiver in Tavion Robinson. A lot of missed players there. A lot of big-time players. You're down two quarterbacks. You're down two big-time wide receivers. This is a depleted offense for Virginia Tech that really in the regular season when they had everybody wasn't that good anyways. The Hokies were only averaging 24.8 points per game. Their main strength was the run game. The Hokies did average over 190 rushing yards per game. They did that with Raheem Blackshear, the former Rutgers star. Blackshear, 700 yards on the ground and 6 touchdowns. So really, this is going to be a game where I believe Virginia Tech has to lean more on the run game. What else are you going to do? It's been your strength all year, and obviously the passing game can almost be a non-factor. Connor Blumrick is going to be the assumed starter for this game, but he was a third-string quarterback, hardly any experience at all. Hardly any pass attempts this year. So that's a major concern if you're Virginia Tech going into this game. You're down two quarterbacks. You're down your top two wide receivers. You're going to try to run the ball. How well does Blumrick play? A quarterback, so many questions on offense, again, for an offense that was mediocre at best for the entirety of the regular season. When you look at the defense, Maryland's probably licking their chops, right? They're probably really excited that they're facing a Virginia Tech offense that's so depleted. The thing is, Maryland's defense wasn't all that great. So despite being depleted, Virginia Tech might be able to exploit this Terrapins defense. You know, Maryland allowed 32.4 points per game, and we're giving up over 250 passing yards per game. But for me, if I'm Maryland, if I'm a Maryland fan, I'm not too worried about that. You know, if I'm Maryland, I want Virginia Tech to throw because of how depleted their quarterback room and wide receiver room is. The major number that I'm looking at is the fact that Maryland was giving up over 155 rushing yards per game. So not a great mark going up against Virginia Tech's strength. Again, the Hokies averaging over 190 rushing yards per game. And look at these numbers here. Maryland gave up 164 rushing yards to Rutgers, 151 to Michigan, 194 to Michigan State, 204 to Indiana, 326 to Minnesota, 166 to Ohio State, and the list goes on. They give up some big yards on the ground. And Virginia Tech is going to see that, and they're going to try to exploit that. And Maryland, you've got to find a way to shut that down and force the Hokies to throw. That is how you win this game. When you look at Virginia Tech, they also will be without a few key players on defense. Of course they will be. They will be without their defensive tackle and Jordan Williams. Had 2.5 sacks and 33 tackles on the year. They'll be without their defensive end, Amari Barno, 3.5 sacks, 35 tackles on the year. Their cornerback, Jermaine Waller, 45 tackles, 4 interceptions, led the team. All those are big losses for Virginia Tech. Two guys up front, one guy back in your secondary, and you don't want to lose anybody in your secondary when you're facing the 13th ranked passing defense or offense in the country. Those are some big losses on both sides of the ball for the Hokies. But the Hokies guys, for the most part, had a pretty solid defense for the most of the year. Allowed just 22.9 points per game. And the key number, again, is looking at the passing numbers. How did they stack up against the pass? Well, the Hokies gave up 219.5 passing yards per game. 219.5 passing yards per game. That's the key number. They've got to find a way to somehow slow down Taulia Tagovailoa, slow down this passing attack. Their rushing game gave up over 165 rushing yards per game. So maybe Maryland does try to stay balanced. Maybe they do try to use Fleet Davis a little bit more, try to run the ball, take the pressure off, and obviously set up the pass, exploit the Virginia Tech secondary. Because I would see Maryland trying to do that. I would see Maryland trying to attack on the ground because I want to look at some of the numbers that Virginia Tech has allowed, both on the ground and through the air. We'll start with on the air, 414 passing yards to Virginia, 357 to Miami, 203 to Pittsburgh, and the list goes on. They're vulnerable. They're vulnerable across the board. They're even more vulnerable with these opt-downs. So Virginia Tech, again, the key is going to be stopping the pass, forcing Maryland to run, but giving up over 165 rushing yards per game on average makes me believe that Maryland will have some success on the ground. Might be able to be one of the more balanced offensive games of the year for Mike Locksley and the Terrapins. So what's going to happen in the Pinstripe Bowl? What do we have? Who do we have winning? I could actually see this guy's genuinely being a close game. Despite all the opt-outs for Virginia Tech, everything like that, I could see this being a relatively close game. But obviously, from everything that we've said, everything that I'm sure you've looked at, it's clear that one team is better than the other. One team is better physically, they're better mentally, and that team is Maryland. So we are going to go with the Terrapins in this game. I believe they are more motivated than Virginia Tech. They're playing in their first bowl game since 2016, trying to win their first bowl game since 2010. Hardly any opt-outs. Obviously aren't dealing with a brand new coach. You know, the motivation is high. It is there for Maryland. Virginia Tech, not so much. So many players are gone, especially on offense. Can't help but wonder, will Virginia Tech even be able to eclipse maybe, what, 14 points? A lot of questions on the offensive side of the ball. And you can't help but wonder, are the Hokies already checked out? They're looking forward to the Brent Pry era, ready just to get to 2022. And this game is just more of an obligation, something they've got to do rather than something they want to do. I'm going to go with Maryland here, guys. I believe they have everything they need to win this game and possibly win it convincingly. And the Terrapins under Mike Locksley, guys, finally get a bowl win, finally get there to a bowl game, and then they're going to win it, and they're going to carry some momentum into what could be a big 2022 for them. So guys, as always, thank you so much for watching us here at the Gridiron Expert on YouTube. Make sure to continue to like, comment, subscribe, share our videos, and of course, check out everything down in the description below. Again, sign up for those expert picks over on the gridironexpert.com. Again, it will be one of the best deals, one of the best prices, one of the best marks that you will find anywhere. I can promise you that. TheGridironExpert.com. Join our team today. It's a year-long subscription. You do not want to miss out on it. And once again, guys, as always, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time right here on The Gridiron Expert.